please help me welcome Michael Hauser.
Well, this is really exciting to be here, and Barbara's been such a supporter of all of us that do this strange art form that I, first of all, want to thank her and the library. I'm going to chat a little bit, some background of myself and all of us in flamenco here in the Midwest. At this point in one's life, I find myself thinking a lot about my teachers when I play, and I had some wonderful, wonderful teachers, all wonderful gentlemen. Some of them were gitanos, gypsies, some weren't. And I've studied with a number of people. My brother Tony and I spent several months studying with Nino Ricardo, one of the real legends of flamenco. And he'd always, as was the custom, greet us at the door in his bathrobe and teach that way. And then to make things worse, he had the window open and it was over a very busy street in Madrid. And so all you could hear were the diesel buses going by and we couldn't hear our lesson. But then to make things worse, we didn't realize what he was teaching us. He was creating at the moment. He was one of the great innovators and creators of flamenco music. Paco de Lucia studied with him. So we'd go back for our lesson a couple days later and would have forgotten what he showed us, but he forgot it too. So I said to Tony, we better concentrate on this. Then I've had my last teacher was another great innovator in flamenco, Juan Maya Marrote, and we became very, very good friends. He's passed away, and we bonded because both our fathers were not doing well at that time. And he actually invented one of the flamenco techniques that are used today. So in the two solos that I'm going to play, the first one is called Rondeña, the second is Soleá por Bulerías, are heavily influenced by all of these guys. Sometimes I'll play some of their falsettas, and the way I do it, half of my music is mine, the other half is to the great maestros that I've studied with.
Thank you.
I would like to introduce Pedro Cortés, who will talk about the Gypsy influence, and Señor Jesus Montoya.
Que ni me mira, ni me mira, es que ni me mira, ni me hable.
La la la. Gracias. Gracias.
No, the Gypsies consider ourselves a race of people, like the Jews consider themselves a race of people. Originally, the Gypsies came from India, and they traveled down from India, and there's many, many theories how they got into Europe or whatever, so I don't really want to get into that, because that could be argued by scholars, really, so everybody has an opinion on how that happened, but the origin of the Romani, which we speak a dialect called Caló in Spain. And that originally comes from Sanskrit, and it comes from India. Yeah, it takes a long time to make this. I was just talking to Tony, we're talking to Dan before, and we're talking about this. It takes years to learn the language of flamenco, because flamenco is a language. When you learn the language of flamenco, you can get on, you can improvise, you can get to the point where it's always so fresh, because it's happening on the moment. And every combination of dancers with singers and guitars you get will be totally different, depending on how the styles that everybody works in. So that's why it's always so fresh. And it's so diverse, because there's so many, within the form, so many different styles. So once you learn the language of flamenco, it is an incredible art form. And that's I think, what projects, is when you get to that point that you learn the language of flamenco, not just learn like a form here and there when you play that, you know. That's very limiting, but once you get to the point where you can actually just flow in the form, you know, in flamenco, it's just a wonderful experience. Thank you.
andará a mi muchacho. Ay, casi tres días que yo no lo vi, que loco, ¿dónde andará? Andará bebiendo vino o andará por ahí borracho.
In the year 2012, they're beginning to write it down, but traditionally it's not written down. It looks kind of weird on paper when you write it down, because of the way it's phrased, it wasn't something that was meant to be written down, so it looks a little bit bizarre on paper sometimes. But it is written down now, but traditionally it's something that's passed down from son, you know, from your grandchildren, you pass it on to your children, it's something in the family that gets passed down. Friends hang out in the street. They look at the new letra that I came up with. And the other guy's, wow, look what I came up with. And and they exchange, like people play baseball or basketball here in the streets. You know, in Andalusia, a lot of the kids exchange musical farseta ideas and singing, and that still exists very much still in Andalusia.
De ir al mismo mundo. Ay, luna, quédate conmigo, no te vayas, porque a veces mami que se llevará el bao, que se llevará.
tu amor, no me digas que voy a perderte, no me quieras matar el corazón. Hay una vez yo te dije te quiero, y una vez me dijiste que no, pero la vez que yo te dije te quiero, no supe decirte, decirte que no, pero la vez que yo te dije te quiero, no supe decirte, decirte que no.
Pedro Cortés.
The most important.
That's too many questions, huh? Excuse me, without sorry, honey. But I love you anyway.
The most important part of flamenco. Without flamenco, I always say that without the cante, without the singing, we have fla. The flamenco is gone without it. Because what actually creates, what creates the forms is the cante. Because I can play within one form, but that could be more than one form. Because I'm playing within a key and within a rhythm. But that can turn into many different things depending on what's being sung. So the singing is what determines what form we're actually doing. So the most important part is the singing. And when there's a dance going on, your question is, we're following the dance until the dance calls the singing in. When the dance calls the singing in, we're following the singer. Once he's done singing, then we're back to following the dancer. But it's all, and everything you see tonight is improv. We haven't rehearsed anything. So everything is being made up on the spot.
Wow.
And as you're gonna see with the dancer with Susana, it's all improv also. She can sing, dance whatever escobilla she wants, and she can ask Jesus to sing as many letras as she wants, and he can sing whatever letras he wants, whatever styles he wants, and we all have to follow what he's singing during those parts.
Ladies and gentlemen, Susana Di Palma, Sorongo, Flamenco, ole.
Oye, Miguel, marcha. Yo no te obligo, yo no te obligo, gitana, y aunque me quieran tu gente, yo te echo un juramento de paz, pagarte con la muerte. Vinieron y me dijeron que tú hablaste muy mal de mí. Mira si vivo con pena que yo me quisiera morir. Thank you. yo tiro piedra por
Susana. Hola, Susana, gracias, señora.